Okay.
Hospital. Let's talk about the United Medical Center. People have criticized you for getting too hands-on with that hospital, that you act like you're running the place. So since you're allegedly and accused of running the place, tell us the good news about the place.
So this year, the hospital will turn its first profit in more than two decades, period. It is, according to the Hospital Association and the CEOs of the city, what has happened there is nothing short of a miracle. In 2010, the hospital lost almost $10 million. The city took it over, foreclosed in July 2010, and for this fiscal year, according to the latest financials we've seen, it will have an operating surplus of in excess of $8 million, allows it to fully fund its operating capital, its capital expenditures, and will end the year with a profit of nearly $4 million. Now, you will recall when Nat Gandhi, our CFO, testified before my committee in July of 2010, he said this hospital had a net deficit of $30 million.
It's a drag on the city's finances.
And would lose between $750 and $1.2 million a month, essentially $30 million in the hole and lose $15 million a year. I explained to him at the time that we had undertaken a number of actions, and yes, I'll claim to be the architect of this. I brought Children's National Medical Center there with a world-class pediatric ER. I brought Washington Hospital Center there to take over obstetrics. I brought Howard University there to take over HIV/AIDS and the National Institutes of Health and a bunch of other public-private partnerships. We have turned that hospital around through increasing not only patient throughput, but also quality of service. And so we will end this year with a hospital that is not a drag, but one that actually makes money. Now, as far as a $30 million hole, the entire amount that the hospital owes from the pre-July 9th, 2010 operations is $3 million, period. So we have $3 million in a hospital that's generating enough money to not only pay for that, but service all of its operating needs going forward and can continue to expand.
If you have questions or comments about United Medical Center or anything else that Councilmember Catania is involved with, call us at 800-433-8850. You can send email to kojo@wamu.org. Join the conversation at our website, kojoshow.org.
I don't want to get bogged down in the numbers too much, but when you say it's going to, how much is the profit? $4 million?
The profit will be $4 million, on about $103 million in operations. So that's a pretty hefty return.
What is the period of time? Is that as of
1 year.
As of today, September 30th?
Yes, October 1st of last year to September 30th of this year.
And all the bills have been paid? All the bills, they're not bills outstanding?
Well, I mean, in any operation, you're going to have accounts payable and accounts receivable. So you've got money that's due you and money you owe others.
One of the, I call the chief financial officer's office, which I know you have great disagreements with, said one of the issues is whether or not the bills are being paid on time.
Right. Well, one of the issues I have with the chief financial officer is that when he assumed the responsibility for the books, one of his first things he did last March 1st was to fire the director of patient financial services. This is the entity that actually aggressively goes out and collects your accounts receivable. Before he fired that particular entity, the Chappelle Group, which is a district company, we were collecting $7.6 million a month. After he fired them, we were collecting $6.4 million. So we collect $1.2 million less per month over a six-month period because he was responsible for hiring the person. He fired them, didn't replace them, allowed 6 months to go by. And so I think our bottom line would be much stronger had he not done that. He as much as admitted it yesterday.
On the bottom line then, because if the hospital is doing as well, and except that you say it is doing well, so it's doing well, is this an argument for the city to continue to run the hospital?
No.
You know, the mayor and
no,
the,
it's not.
The chairman
good,
and they all want to sell not, the
what
hospital.
Do you see as the alternative?
Is this an argument you're saying the hospital is in a better position now to attract buyers?
That's right. Look, I've said, you know, the mayor uses the term one city all the time. But if we are going to be one city, then it needs to be one city, which means if I get in a car accident on Western Avenue, I have the same expectation of health care if I get in a car accident on Southern Avenue. If I live on North Capitol or South Capitol, it shouldn't matter. And for years, politicians have talked about this institution. They pretend to care about the residents of 7 and 8. By the way, this last fiscal year, 107,000 patients went through that hospital. There's no entity that touches the residents of that community more than that one hospital. And so, you know, I believe it should have world-class pediatrics and obstetrics, as well as wound care, as well as mental health services, etc. That's why we brought these marquee partners. At the same time, I'm also mindful of my responsibility to the Treasury. What I want to do, and I'll wrap up, Tom, is I want to make sure we get one, hopefully 2 years of good financials, where we can show through audited financials that we have turned the corner. And how did we do this on the revenue side? We aggressively went after increased reimbursements for Medicaid. We redistributed the DSH dollars, which are disproportionate share hospital dollars that Medicaid gives cities to pay for the uncompensated care. Before I came along, that hospital received 10% of the city's DSH allocations. Our latest audit shows they provide 40% of the care. Now, how was that fair? And so by fighting for a level playing field, we've leveled the financial situation, we've improved the scope and quality of services, and I believe in 1 year or two, this hospital will be so attractive, it will be the kind of facility that a MedStar wishes to have in its constellation. But it isn't there yet, and I fear that if we sell it before we have audited financials, it's an invitation to mischief for those who would just come and actually
bleed it.
Right.